For more on the meeting, I'm joined now by Robert Hanlon. He's a political scientist and consultant. Robert, I want to ask you, first of all, what do you make of the outcome of this two-day meeting in Luxembourg?
Thanks very much for having me. It really does show the importance of the AIIB extending outside of Asia. I find, you know, some of the bigger themes, we had big themes around climate change, the environment, social and governance themes, and just the overall message that this isn't really a China owned and run bank. It really is a multilateral development bank with many shareholders, lots of stakeholders, and has serious ambitions in improving development in the regions.
How do you think the AIIB can really strengthen Eurasian cooperation and connectivity? That was the point, the specific focus of this meeting.
Well, you know, we do have a massive infrastructure development gaps, not only in Asia, but Central Asia and Eastern Europe and other parts of the world. I mean, the AIIB fills this this gap. It has the opportunity to do this. It's been referred to by some as a, you know, as this kind of pluralistic, competitive institution, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's a negative thing. It's something that can enhance and work with partners to help improve development, in especially in lower income countries where we have marginalized and vulnerable populations. There's really a key development approach here. And so, you know, the AIIB has this capacity with its partners in Europe, and not only in the state capacity, but also the private sector.
How significant do you think it was having this meeting for the first time outside of the Asian continent? Some people say, you know, Europe is the IMF's backyard, even if unofficially.
Yeah, it's very important. I mean, there's a few reasons. Obviously, there's this, the optics, the message that this isn't just an a China driven bank. It's not just an Asian bank. It is a trying to engage and be wired into the global community. Luxembourg is a great natural selection. I mean, it is the headquarters of the European Infrastructure Investment Bank. It has a lot of like-minded support in Luxembourg. So, you know, not only does it speak to that, but it also allows this beginning of this very early bank to start building relationships outside its region, and also just the bigger theme of cooperation, connectivity. I mean, these are big themes of trust, and so trying to kind of build trust with Europe, especially as there's a new European leadership coming in, which is not entirely favorable or a little skeptical would be more accurate of China's rise and this competition. So it's very important to have this meeting in Luxembourg.
And very briefly, we've got about 30 seconds left, and I wanted to ask you, has there been any impact on the AIIB from the U.S.-China trade war that you've seen?
I mean, it is something that is obviously it's the elephant in the room. It's something that I'm hoping, my hope is that there's a longer term vision beyond this trade war. But really what it shows is the importance of China and the U.S. And when these two countries are having a trade war, it exposes the vulnerability of the global economy. But it also shows the need of cooperation and trust building. And so I'm feeling very optimistic in the long run, but it's certainly something that is on top of mind.
Robert Hanlon joining us from British Columbia. Thank you so much for your insight.
Thank you.